r/AskReddit. What do you personally view as a scam that everyone accepts otherwise? Hotels charging for Wi-Fi. Also flights. You're telling me I can get free Wi-Fi from libraries, coffee shops, the dentist, and the bus, but I can't get Wi-Fi included with this $189 night room? If I spend more than $2, I want free Wi-Fi. Somehow it's always the more expensive hotels that charge for Wi-Fi too. I went to a hotel that was over $200 night and it didn't include Wi-Fi or breakfast. The next day was at a cheap hotel that was like $60 night and it included free Wi-Fi and breakfast, like WTF. The expensive hotels will have more business class customers who will gladly charge it back to their company. Meanwhile, the Ramadas and Holiday Inns of the world attract tourists with continental breakfast and indoor water parks. Two Pokemon games coming out at once that are almost the exact same. Or one coming out 1 year later with some added and modified content. Upvoting this because it's the first thing I've seen in the thread that is not a widely accepted as a scam. Basically all the two versions games are scams. The only one that really survived was Pokemon. And I don't think it had anything to do with the fact that there are two versions. But if no one is going to boycott the game over it, might as well keep doing it. The GBC GBA era was flooded with games like this. It was popular for a while, but it always seemed bullshit to me as a kid because not only did you need to know someone who had the other version, but you also had to have the magic link cable that no one seemed to own, at least near me. The only exception I know of to this is the Zelda Oracle games. Oracle of Ages and Oracle of Seasons were two entirely different games, and above that you didn't need the link cable to connect the two. You just needed the code you got when you beat the game. Flamingos. They might be real birds, but just barely. They can fly. That makes them more bird than an ostrich or penguin. Be grateful ostriches don't fly. Nah, be grateful emus don't fly. Pointy beaks. Second in the tall stakes and they've been in wars. Slight clarification on the last point. They won a war against Australia, and the Aussies were the ones who declared war on them. When mom says if you tell the truth, I won't get mad. And extra large fleshlights. Wish.com. I do like looking at all the wacky shit on there though. I got a bunch of weird ads for things on Wish that have zero context to them. Like, WTF is this toe torture device you're putting on my Facebook wall? My wife and I did some shopping online and I ended up having to make the Wish ad stop because it was suddenly all very inappropriate. Which was weird to me because none of the shopping was on Wish. I don't understand how so many people fall for their scam. Their business model is dropshipping stuff from AliExpress for a premium while luring you in with scam tactics and fake discounts. You can just buy on AliExpress yourself, you know, which is cheaper, much more transparent, and it's easier to find the higher quality products there too, so you don't get surprised by cheap trash. Credit repair companies. Change.org petitions. Would you like to donate, spread the word? Would you like to sign up for email notifications? Would you like to submit your own petition? Would you like to tell your friends? Would you like to visit our advertisers? Are you sure you wouldn't like to donate? Would you kindly? This one of those threads in which it's best to sort by controversial. Capitalism is both a Ponzi scheme and a pyramid scheme. And the next 20 a religion. Saved you a click. The shopping channel. They just get some common product, slap a few mouthy salesmen on it with an infomercial and sell it for 10x the price. They're just screwing over pre-internet senior citizens. Shopping channels are enjoyed so much by the elderly because many of them are unable to go out to a busy, chaotic shopping mall just to browse shelves once a week. Take that combined with being a couple generations older than the internet, and for many of them QVC is even more accessible than Amazon. I'm an IT for a realty company. Trust me, some old-fashioned types just refuse to learn. The South Park about cash for gold was def a real thing about real ripoffs, to be sure. But HSN QVC's mere existence offer a benefit to many individuals who are no longer or who have never been able-bodied. My wife and I ducking love watching QVC. Just seeing the nonsense they sell on there is great. Never ordered anything. Just here for the laughs. And paid internships. If you look at the actual laws, internships are supposed to be primarily focused on education if the intern is doing work that is providing value to the company. They are supposed to be paid. It's just never enforced. There was a lawsuit some time ago about these two unpaid interns who worked on a movie. I want to say Black Swan? Not sure. Who were working crazy hours. One of them allegedly overheard a boss saying that if they didn't have the interns they would have to hire someone to replace them and it wasn't in budget. I don't remember the result of the lawsuit, but I remember this making major headlines. Transaction processing fees when you order a digital product online. Such as a concert ticket. You pay 16 bucks extra while you pay online, and then have to print the ticket yourself. All fees are bullshit and are designed to either hide the price of the original product or are an excuse for a middleman to cash in. Rental. Home's property management company moved to another state and sent out a ton of emails pushing everyone to start paying rent using their online portal. I got it all set up and then discovered that they were adding a $50 processing fee on top of the rent. $50. Nope. I'll keep on using snail mail to get that check delivered for the cost of a stamp. Thanks. Many banks will send the check for you as part of their bill pay service. It won't even cost you a stamp. Priority boarding for airlines. Personally, if I paid extra, I would want to be the last person on the plane. I sit down. We go. I won't pay extra to make my plane time longer by 30 minutes just to have 100 people bump into me as they board. Unless you need overhead bin space for your bag, shakes fist at sky. Buying college textbooks. I had several teachers in college that made you buy the textbook that they had written. I had a psychology professor in college who made us buy a tiny $60 book, the most expensive book of my college career. This was back when a thick calculus or organic chemistry textbook cost around $35. It was written by a friend of his. We only used one page of the book. JC, I'd skin myself for a new $60 text, if you don't mind me asking. When approximately was this? College in America. It's absolutely absurd that they can hold your transcripts hostage. Charge $600 a year for a parking pass, require that the first year be spent on campus. Rotate out a $500 textbook every single semester that was written by your professor, and basically can find any other way to outrageously overcharge students while promoting predatory lending and saying they're not for profit. And then asking alumni for donations. Since all of that apparently isn't enough. You spent it already? I gave you more money than the Civil War cost. And you ducking spent it already? This is a good John Mulaney reference. You forgot an old classic. Meal plans. Where they make you pay more than it would cost to feed you for the year. And the meal credits don't roll over to next year. Without fail towards the end of the year, college students scramble to use the in my experience is several hundred dollars left over from the trash meal plan on shit at the campus store. The most egregious thing I saw was a regular case of 24 Poland Spring water bottles for $25. I think my rant kinda went off the proverbial rails, so to clarify, duck colleges. The funeral industry. Poor families get robbed of so much money just to put on a respectful funeral. And because they're grieving. It's seriously kicking them while they're down. You don't need to pay hundreds or thousands of dollars to have grandma embalmed. Made up with corpse makeup. Put in a casket worth an arm and a leg. And lowered into a hole filled with roses. To be topped with an ornate expensive headstone. I wish natural burials were more mainstream. Where the body is put in its favorite outfit, wrapped in a biodegradable sheet, and placed in a mound of dirt to be absorbed by the earth. Big funeral companies are benefiting off of people's grief and it's disgusting. Agree, and I feel this after having to bury both of my parents within the last 6 years. And heaven forbid there were no prepaid funeral arrangements and you have to wait on life insurance to pay out or try and get third-party financing to be reimbursed once life insurance money comes in. My mother passed on a holiday weekend, so we could not even reach the right people to help with the process and it was a nightmare. Subscriptions like Xbox Live Gold, PlayStation Plus, etc. It feels odd to have to own a console plus monitor slash TV, buy a game, have an already paid internet subscription and then above that, before you can even play the game. Not all of them. It's clearly stated which games you need a subscription for and which not. You need a paid subscription to your console's online service. They aren't too expensive, but it just feels a little odd. I do not own any consoles myself, nor am I trying to speak bad about console players. It just feels odd to me personally. As a guy who owns multiple consoles and has accepted this is now standard practice and pay for it, I still agree with you. The worst part is, not every game is multiplayer, I know, crazy, and most games don't have dedicated servers. So why the premium? I'm just glad that they decided to include the hardware to connect online, as well as ditching the add-on mentality. I liked original Xbox because it had an internal hard drive, 4 controller ports, and Ethernet port built in. PS2 you needed to buy an adapter for internet, adapter for 4 player, and memory cards. PS3 had everything built in, and free online service. Xbox 360 required purchase of a hard drive originally, Wi-Fi adapter, though it had an Ethernet port, separate HD DVD drive, and then you had to pay to connect online too. So at least things have progressed to where they eliminated the add-on adapter philosophy. I'll take my wins where I can. Any seminar entitled Secrets to Building Your Wealth or something in a similar vein. The only secret is that you attending is building some other person's wealth. Beware the advice of successful people. They do not seek company. Dogbert. My mother poured $12,000 into the pockets of the rich dad. Poor dad a-hole for classes on real estate for herself and her boyfriend. Then she went to class to get her real estate license. Didn't pay attention to the deadlines on her credits, and ran out the deadline before her exam. So she couldn't sit for her license exam. So she has literally less than nothing to show for it. Meanwhile, my sister and Bill, who have a 6-year-old, spent time homeless due to my mother's decisions when my sister was a teenager, and are on the verge of declaring bankruptcy because she will do nothing to help. Instead, she dropped over 10 grand on gold and silver coins, because she thinks those will help her survive the prophesied recession. Life coaching. Wealth building. Yada yada yada. Life coaching is like giving a therapist license to control your life, which is why therapy is great and life coaching is not. A therapist leads the horse to the water and leaves the option to drink the water up to the horse. A life coach takes a horse and force feeds it hay. However, having a solid mentor, business, life, spirituality, is awesomely beneficial. Everyone should have someone they look up to that can help lead them through some of life's muddy decisions. Donating on GoFundMe, edit, not the company itself. The scammer users, you never know if they're pocketing your money or using your money for what they said the cause is. I had no idea they take such a big cut until I organized one for a fellow hockey player to get his mouth put back together. Here in Aus, a lot of pointless store warranties and such to cover you if it breaks or needs to be replaced. Mother ducker no. This is Australia, not America. If you sell me a product that is faulty or breaks in an unreasonable time frame, or breaks during reasonably foreseeable use, all I have to do is prove it came from you. Don't even need a receipt if I can do it another way. Bank statement for instance, and you are providing me a replacement or full refund in the method you initially received payment. Because that's how our consumer law works. So Syntercom, feel free to take your restocking fee up with Australian consumer law, not me. Pancake mix. You literally only need flour and baking powder plus a bit of salt. That's it. That's all it is. The liquid ingredients, milk, eggs, are still the same. Don't spend your money on box pancake mix. I'm not paying for the product, I'm paying for the convenience. I only get the complete mix, and it's worth the $1.50 to $2, probably overpaying by $1, to be able to just throw it in a bowl with water. I am paying to reduce the risk of me ducking something up. Payment plans for phones and just paying $1,000 for a phone in general. And upgrading your phone every 18 months. My last phone lasted 4.5 years. Psychics. How do these people live with themselves when they are taking advantage of people in their time of mourning loss? It's cheaper to go a therapist. I read this as physics and was very confused. Any kind of over-the-counter pill, vitamin, cream or personal cleansing product that is usually unisex but claims that this particular one is for men or women only. It's the same razor model but in a different color. Gillette, I'm onto your shit. Also, I don't even like the color blue, I like pink. You sexist duckers. Microtransactions and games that you paid $60 to play in the first place. But I don't buy them. They don't affect me. Yes, they do. If we don't say anything, The publishers are going to push for microtransactions in more and more games until you are affected. And then what? Weddings. Department store credit cards. I know so many young people who are drowning in debt because a perky cashier offered to save them 10% by opening a card. TBF, most credit cards and scams. It's carelessness and spending money you don't have that makes people suffer. It's definitely exploitative of the uneducated or impulsive, but it's not a scam. So-called body cleanses. Whether it be juice, herbal pills or something else. College universities. The makeup fashion industry. Popcorn prices at the cinema. Any company that makes you go to their dealers for repairs, like Apple, just so you have to pay triple the amount. If you had gotten an Android and watched a YouTube video, you could have fixed the problem yourself in 20 minutes for about 10 bucks. Cutco and Vector Marketing. They hired so many of my old peers in high school and took advantage of the whole community. Greeting cards. I never buy one. I can just call the person and say things to them. My wife insists on getting them for everything. She has a phone for duck's sake. Call someone and say happy birthday. Call someone and say I ducked your mom. You don't need a card for that. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.